month, we have been talking about October Cruise Month on account of it being October. And these days, it seems like there is a themed cruise for every type of hobby or interest you might have. Joining us now is AAA Travel expert Lisa Anciaux. Hello there.
Hello, hello.
There really is something for everybody.
You know, there really is. And whether you're interested in food and wine, whether you're interested in music, whether you're interested in quilting, quilt cruises, history from lectures on board, artwork. I mean, there is something for everyone's interest.
It's so fun, and then you meet other people who have the same interest. So that's kind of fun as well. Mm-hmm. So let's talk about one I would love, the Rock and Roll Cruise.
I know, this is very special that we have with Royal Caribbean, and we're doing two of these to the Caribbean next year and one to Alaska right out of Seattle, which is fabulous. Oh. And it's called Rockin' the Caribbean, mm-hmm. Which is going to be a lot of fun on the beautiful Oasis of the Seas. And not only is this a great ship, but it has something for everyone itself too. I love this picture. This kind of shows the aft of the ship, and it shows the big theater back there where they do great diving performances into the pool. They have acrobatic performances that go on. You can see some of the cabins on the inside there.
Look at
this. Zip lining through the ship. You can ice skate on top of that on that ship. You can do rock climbing. So besides that, we've got this Rock and Roll Cruise that's going to be going on with Rocky and the Rollers, mm-hmm. is going to be on performing, which is just fabulous. They do such a great job. Other performers are going to be on, like Bowser, who used to be with Shanana, but he's now with the Stingrays. He still does that iconic pose right there. Peggy March, she's saying, "I Will Follow You."
Yes,
you know,
yes.
That song. Some of these just old 60s and 70s musics. You know, the Mystics. We got the Flamingos on. I mean, it is just a great source of the Dixie Cups. I mean, just some of these old iconic songs and musics that are going on.
How
Gary
long are
Lewis,
the cruises?
7-day Caribbean
Seven
cruise.
Days. Okay.
And what's nice about it also is, again, it's not the entire cruise. There's all sorts of other things to do.
Right.
So you have someone else who's not that interested in that type of music, they can do something else. Round trip out of Cape Canaveral, easy to get to, out of Orlando, mm-hmm. fly into Orlando, make a great vacation.
Absolutely. Okay, let's talk about my other favorite thing besides rock and roll music, food. So there are cruises with the culinary experience.
Yeah, we do. We have great culinary cruises, and two that are kind of fun and close to home are on American Queen, which is right here in our own, you know, United States, going mm-hmm. up the rivers. Mm-hmm. And one is American Culinary. And it's going to talk about the history of American food, how things came about, lots of cooking demonstrations. Both of these are in July. Then we have another one, which is the Bourbon Run, which we've talked a little bit about.
If we could just combine this, where you could make me one that's cooking
rock and roll and bourbon, we'd be good.
Then I'd be so there. What is happening here?
We talk about the cruise. So a lot of the famous chefs that have now combined or hooked themselves up with the cruise lines, Guy Fieri,
yes.
he has a burger joint. He also has the Anchor and Pig on Carnival Cruise Line. Jacques Poupin has a restaurant, a French restaurant on the Oceana ships, and it's all of his own artwork there. Jamie Oliver has the Italy on
him.
Royal Caribbean also. That's his restaurant. I mean, and if you want to try some of these foods, it's their recipes. We've got Curtis Stone has Cher on Princess, and it's all about sharing bites. Thomas Keller on Seabourn. So you get to experience their food, their recipes on these ships, which is mm-hmm. fun. They're not on every single ship. So like Guy Fieri's burger is not on every Carnival ship. Use your travel agent to figure out which ship they're on. We usually find them on the newer ships that are being built out there.
Tell us about the bourbon.
Bourbon cruise again. And again, that American.
Where's the bourbon cruise?
And, you know,
that's what I want to know.
It's also about cooking with bourbon, right? The barbecues. This is all in Kentucky. I mean, Kentucky bourbon, barbecuing, mm-hmm. cooking. Oh.
Yes.
A little tasting along the way.
Yes, yes.
We're talking good stuff.
And then wine cruises as well.
Wine cruises are always very popular, especially in Europe. We have one on Cunard next June doing the port areas of Portugal and the wine country of Spain. To me, this one is the hot one right now because it's a 7-day cruise, round trip out of Southampton, going to all these wonderful places, wine tasting, wine lectures on board, starting at $1,085 per person for a 7-day cruise on the Queen Victoria, on the Queen Victoria Cunard. So it is, to me, hot right now.
That's Let's the all best sign pricing. Up right away. Yeah, and so AAA is also doing your Soap for Hope campaign. We want to talk
it's
about
our,
this.
Yes, please. It's our 10-year anniversary of doing
Congrats.
Soap for Hope. So we're really proud of that. You can donate any personal goods like soaps, toothbrush, toothpaste, shampoos, travel size, regular size. You can go to any of our stores. We have the big bins there, and they go to 25 different charities all across Washington State. So our stores, wherever they are, like if it's our Alderwood store, they usually donate to the Domestic Violence Center. So we have all different charities
that's
that
great.
It goes to.
Thank
so
you.
Please stop by, drop off a donation.
Yeah, and that's an easy item
easy
to get
item to do.
And drop off.
Yep.
Lisa, thank you very, very
you
much.
Bet.
So to learn more about these cruises or to book your next vacation anywhere you want to go, just give the agents at AAA Travel a call and they can help you out. We will be right back.